All right, folks, this is a fabulous creme brulee recipe. White chocolate, rum raisin, eggnog, creme brulee. You're gonna love making this recipe. Really, really quick video today. You're gonna love it. Remember, give us a thumbs up if you like the recipe. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to ring the bell. So every Thursday, you get a notification when we put out a new video. So you're gonna love this one. You gotta make it. Well, welcome back, everyone. I have one of my favorite desserts. I love to make creme brulee. And for the holidays, I decided I'm going to make an eggnog creme brulee. Little rum, little cognac, little rum raisin. And instead of using sugar, I use white chocolate. So you guys got to check this recipe out. It's really amazing. It's very simple to make. So stay tuned and we're going to start doing it right away, okay? So I'm going to make 4 creme brulee, which means I need 4 egg yolks. Cream, I need a half a cup per, so I got 2 cups of cream for 4. High mathematics here. So instead of using sugar, which you could certainly use sugar, I like to use white chocolate. You know, white chocolate is mostly sugar. So what I'm putting, I'm using about a half of an ounce of white chocolate per serving. And that's usually enough sugar, but if it's not enough sugar for you, you can add a little bit of brown sugar. That's what I would add in those creme brulee. I'm also gonna add a little bit of maple syrup. Add as much as you want, but not too much, because we don't want it to make it too sweet, right? Just a little bit of maple syrup, carefully measured. You don't have to be measured, put a little bit more. You know, the idea for sugar, you know what I do for sugar? I test it. So I may follow somebody's recipe once in a while, and then I make it, you know, since I never made it before. And here's what I recommend you do. You test it to see if you like it. Is it enough sugar for you? It's too much sugar? Oh, well, you can't take it out. So next time you put a little bit less sugar. So we got the white chocolate that is melting in here, and we got the 4 eggs, and I'm going to put a little bit of cinnamon and a little bit of nutmeg. And I mean little, okay? I don't want it to be overwhelming. So I put just a little bit of this right here. And let me tell you what I like to do when I do it. I like to mix it up with the egg. I do the same when I do the cocoa powder. First, you see, look, mix it up really good. It's a good trick. When you're doing spices, you want it to really, 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 really be mixed well first. You see, don't put too much, eh? Right, just like this. And then we're gonna put a little bit of cognac. Now, you don't have to put cognac and rum in there. It'll be perfectly good without it. Ooh. But I think it'll be perfectly better if you put it in there, okay? Don't put too much. For the kids, though. My mom used to put a lot of booze on it. Actually, you know what? You give them that dessert, they go to sleep really quick. So, shh, don't say I said it. Don't tell anybody. I can hear the YouTube recipe police already. Aye, aye, aye. I'm going to get some comment on that one. Don't give it the food. Don't give it the booze to the kids. I understand. Look. I got raisins that have been marinated in Captain Morgan spice rum. Now, those, you give those to the kids in the morning with a cereal. Oh, they'll have a great day at school. Don't say anybody, please. Look, so I got them marinated. Look. Look, you think that I got enough right there? This is what I use to put in my stuffing for the holidays. I put it in creme brulees. I put it in so many preparations. I make a port wine sauce with mushroom with the marinated raisin, drunken raisins. Oh, it's delicious. Look, you put your raisin right there. Let me tell you, you don't like raisins? You put dry fruit like cranberries, it'll be delicious in there, cherries, dry fruits. You rehydrate it in whatever booze you want. If you don't want to rehydrate them in booze, you rehydrate them in juice, like an apple juice. Huh?
Yeah, I guess it'd be good.
I'd rather do it in booze if you don't mind, okay? So look, guys, now we're going to do what is called tempering the egg, right? This is the easiest, probably going to be the quickest recipe I've ever done for you guys, because there's not much to teach you right here. Look, you put the cream slowly, okay? Look, put it in slowly so you're tempering the egg. You don't cook them, right? Oh, wow. It smells amazing already, I'm telling you. It really does. It's fabulous. Look, all right, so here we have it right there. And now what we're going to do, we're going to take a ladle And we're going to pour right on top of our creme brulee deal. You see, look. And then we're going to cook it in a water bath. That means we're going to put water in that dish. You always want to make sure, friends, you cook your custard at a very low temperature for a long time. Believe it or not, I don't like to go higher than 250, 275, depends your oven, right? 250, oh, 250, 275, don't go higher than that. For an hour and a half, go for a long time. Custard should be cooked for a long time at a low temperature. Long time for low temperature, and wait until you see, because I will show you when they come out of the oven how creamy and how creamy and beautiful they are. And you know what we're going to do? On top of it to finish them up, instead of putting regular sugar, I'm going to put sugar in the raw. Yeah, sugar in the raw. And that sugar is going to give us a nice crust. Look how beautiful that is, right? So now, water bath. Water bath, I'm ready. Look at this. I got the whole thing right here. Water bath, so look. Do this and put it right in there like that. Water bath, you want to go about halfway, okay? About halfway in your lasagna pan. I have a seal pad in the bottom so they don't slide, but you don't need it. Just a regular, right? Now we're going to go to the oven. This is usually where I screw up. Not because I drank a little bit of the rum I put in there. I didn't do that. But usually, it, you know what's smarter to do? It's not what I'm doing. Look at that. This guy's giving us advice on what not to do. Fill up the water when you get inside the oven. It's easier so you don't screw it up. So I'm going to cook them for about an hour and a half. And then I'm going to let them cool. They got to cool in the refrigerator 6 to 8 hours. It's even better overnight. So we're going to take them out of the water, and then we'll come back when they're all done, and I'm going to show you how to burn the, and we're going to use sugar in the raw, R-A-W, for you, for those of you that are not understanding what I'm talking about. Sugar in the raw, and then we're going to burn them. And then I'm going to eat one, because I love it. It's one of my favorite desserts. So we'll be back when they are cooled and done and ready to eat. Okay, well, they come out of the oven. We put them in a refrigerator. First, you wait a little bit until they get to room temperature, right? A couple of hours. Then you put them in the fridge. It's best if you do them overnight. Creme brulee is not like you make and, oh, you got to have dinner now. You make them the day before. It's easier, especially those. And so we have them. They're refrigerated. So now we're going to put a topping on it. And in order to get a nice golden brown like this, we're going to do a topping. How do we do it? Well, you can put regular sugar. A lot of people put regular sugar on it, and they do it. I don't use regular sugar. I use sugar in the raw. See right there? Look, I took a box of it so you guys can see what it looks like. Sugar in the raw. It's a crunchy brown sugar. It's like a light brown sugar. It's crunchy. And I love it. It's also called Turbinado sugar, okay, cane sugar, and you can get it at the grocery store. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that sugar, and the reason why I do this with this sugar, and see the way I do it, by the way, I put it in just like this, right? And the reason why I do this sugar, friends, instead of regular sugar, is because it gives you more of a crunch. Give you more of a crunch, that's all. That's all it does. It just gives you a nice crunch on it. So when you eat it, you got the crunch in the mouth, and then underneath, you got the creamy texture. So to finish it, you can do, you can buy one of those little torch. Then you can buy like at the store, like Bed Bath & Beyond, a great store. I love Bed Bath & Beyond. They got everything in there. You can use that those little torch, about $40, $50, and you do about 50 creme brulee. Or you go to Home Depot and you get one of those, and this is about $15, $16, I think. I don't remember exactly, but under $20, and you make 6,000 creme brulee. So it's up to you. And like I said, when you're done with this, when you finish with the creme brulee, you can redo your plumbing. You can just like, you can become a plumber. Forget the plumbing, okay? All right, so those are cool because you, and if you buy one of those, one more thing about those, buy them self-starter so you don't need to go put a lighter in there. I hate putting a lighter on a gas coming out, right? So you go, you click it, and it pushes this button and it stays on, right? Let me just do it right there, and then what we're going to do, we're going to burn it. Now be careful, friends, when you do this, You want to do it far away. Don't go too close. If you go too close, you're going to burn the sugar before it has time to melt. You see, you want to do it kind of like far away from it. And that's how you do it. Look, it's pretty simple, right? That's all you do. Up. Now, at this point, friends, you want to make sure you wait. You wait. Be patient. Don't say, oh, let me go take a spoon out of it now. Don't do that. That sugar to burn is about 300 degrees. I've done it, trust me. Where you go, oh, let me test right away, and then all of a sudden the sugar gets stuck on the top of your mouth at 300 degrees. Mamma mia, for a week you can't taste anything. So, but anyway, I did this one in advance so I can eat it. I can check it out for you. I want to show you. Oh, yeah, baby, look at this. Look how beautiful that is. Look at this. The raisins in there. It's absolutely beautiful. So now all I'm going to do is... That's wonderful. Crunchy. So underneath the beautiful custard, I have now here nice and crunchy. This is gorgeous. Friends, you gotta try to make this, but remember, make it in advance. If you don't make it in advance, you're not gonna be able to do that, and they're not gonna come out so good. You gotta make it left in the fridge all night. Remember, if you like this recipe, gives us a thumbs up. Don't forget to ring the bell so you get a notification every Thursday when I do a new recipe. And don't forget to subscribe. We need subscribers. Thanks for watching.